Hi guys, Gutsy Cosplayer back again. Part 27 of my Pokemon Leaf Green walkthrough. Now, last time we beat Sabrina. We beat... Sorry, I can't dig. And we beat Koga. So that was quite entertaining to do. As you can see, I do have somebody on my team at poison, which is a bit of a pain because I don't have any antidotes at the moment. But this episode is not about battles, this is not about training. This episode is about the Safari Zone. So I'm not going to do any training in this, I'm literally going to go through the Safari Zone, catching as many Pokemon as I can get. And hopefully getting some good ones. Okay, so in the Safari Zone there are Pokemon there that are not available anywhere else. So let's go in. Oh, this isn't actually the Safari Zone, what's this? Oh, this is telling me about the prizes I can get. But this isn't where I need to go. Safari Zone is there, so let's just cut this tree and get through. So Fuchsia City is literally like a Pokemon zoo. Here we go, that's where I need to be. For 500 you can play the Safari Zone game. Of course I'd like to play. Now Safari Zone Pokemon are really difficult to catch, especially the level 1, the chances that are available here. But in this episode of Survivor's Zone, I'm literally going in just to try and get the two HMs that are in Survivor's Zone, which is Surf and Strength. Of Execute. This should be quite easy to catch. Level 23. Oh, I didn't, darn it. Anifud. Yeah, in the Survivor's Zone, Pokemon can actually flee. So let's see what's up here. Ah, actually, in the water, using the Super Rod, you can catch quite high-level Pokemon. Oh, let's see what I get. It's a Seaking. I've thrown a Safari Ball, because I've already got a Goldeen, but never mind. It broke out. Just watching carefully. I'm going to run. I'll probably come back into the Safari Zone a later day to catch something like a Dratini. Contains Sunny Day. Oh, Sunny Day is actually quite a good attack, or quite a good move. Increases the strength of fire type attacks. And a Leaf Stone too. Alright. Now in the Safari Zone, if I pause it, you'll see I've got 430 steps left to get all the stuff that I want. I'm trying not to waste any. Try not to waste any steps at all. So I might have to come back. Oh, Doduo, I've already got one of those. I'm not going to bother with it. It's level 26. I caught level 28 on the cycling road. Now, you don't actually have your Pokemon with you, so you can't use repels. No, don't want a Paris, because I've already got one. So the Pokeball there that I missed, which I might come back and get in a minute. Quick Claw. That's actually a really good item, that is. I'm trying desperately not to waste all these... you need Surf to get that, and I don't have it. So you do have to come back into the Safari Zone a couple of times to get what you need to get. Alright, what's down here? I don't want to go that way. A Max Revive, that's very handy. A Max Potion. So I might have to come in a couple of times just to remember which way round I've got to go. Right, Venonat, I've already got one, don't need it. Is this Rest House? So that basically means I can go in there and I can rest up. Another Doduo. So in the Savari Zone, you can actually throw rocks and bait. If you throw bait, the Pokemon's more likely to stick around. If you throw a rock, he's more likely to flee, but he's easier to catch. And there we go, ding dong, game is over. Well, I didn't actually catch any Pokemon at all, and I completely forgot which way I was going. So let's go again. So once you've got Surf, you can come back and you can actually skip most of the bits of the Safari Zone you don't need. Let's see what I get this time. Another Doduo. I'm just trying to use my steps wisely. Trying to take shorter routes if possible. That's a Nidoran female. I already have one. Well, I have a Nidorina and it is shiny, so I don't need that one. There is a chance you can catch shiny Pokemon in the Safari Zone, but it's very, very rare that you do. Well, I don't want to go that way because I've already been that way. What am I getting now? Another Nidoran female. Oh, why did I throw a ball? Sorry, cat, I'm not, you've already been fed. Oh, darn it. Didn't actually want to catch the Nidoran female because I've already got one. I'll probably release it. Stop going back on yourself. I need to go up. Another Nidoran female. Things are cute. I don't have one of those. Excuse me one second. Knock it off! My cat's having his mad half hour. Ooh, Steel Wing. That might be a good attack to put onto Pidgeotto. And a Protein. Let's go over this way. And then down. And he's having his mad half an hour. Ah, so let's see. This should be Gold Teeth. I'll go around, double team, and here should be, you're the first person to reach the secret house. I was going to win, no, win our campaign prize, you have won. I got Surf. So I'm going to go into my HM. Oh, come on, go the right way. And I'm going to my TM case. Teach Surf to my Vaporeon. I think I'm going to take. I think I'm going to knock off Quick Attack. Because it doesn't have the stab bonus. Plus water pulse causes confusion as well. So I've got the gold teeth. I'm going to fish. So if you use the super rod, you can catch Pokemon such as Dratini in here, but it's quite rare. Well, I think I'm just going to run out of my time now. So I've got Surf on my Vaporeon, and I will have to put Strength onto one of my Pokemon. I'm not sure which one yet. You can get quite lost in this Savari Zone. Got Pokemon and things like Rhyhorn, Kangaskhan, and Nidorina. You can only get in the Safari Zone, so. And so I do have a, sneaking feeling that I am going to catch another shiny in this playthrough, but I'm not sure which one. Right, Execute. I'll try and catch an Execute. Never going to use it in my team, but... Execute's watching. There's another survivable sodded. Never actually noticed, but the trainer sprite in this is actually left-handed. So he throws the Pokeballs with his left hand every time. That's strange, that. Nope, nearly. If I don't catch it in the next three balls, then I'll leave it. So you can catch Execute elsewhere, I think. Which is why I don't understand how Gary got an Execute at Lavender Town. Ooh, a Venomoth. I do have a Venonat, but I will have a crack at catching a Venomoth. And then, if necessary, I can release my Venonat. Yeah, I got a Venomoth. Nothing really here. While I'm in here, my step count doesn't go down. How many have I got left? 37. There it is. Ding dong. Time's up. Right, so that's that done. And if I go to the Safari Warden's house, he will give me... Is this the Savari Warden's house? It is, yes. He will give me strength. Yay! And that Pokeball there is quite useful. I've got strength, there we go. Now, who am I going to teach strength to? I've got Venusaur and Sandslash who are able to learn it. Oh. Well, Sandslash already knows Cut, so I'm going to give it to Venusaur. Because I don't really use Poison Powder all that often. I use Sleep Powder more likely. Plus, I can always delete it if I need to and give it to another different Pokemon. There we go. And then strength. It's a big boulder. Yes. Oh, Venusaur, use strength. Found a rare candy. Alright, one thing I am going to do is I am going to go into my TM case and I am going to teach. Where is it? Where is it? Steelwing. I'm going to teach Steelwing to Pidgey up because that's actually quite a nice move. Because Steelwing is a 70 power 90 accuracy. Also may raise the user's defense. So it's nearly twice as, you know, so it's more powerful than Wing Attack, but less accurate. But it is a steel type attack, and we do have two flying attacks already. So I'm going to get rid of Wing Attack and use Steel Wing instead. Yeah, there we go. So that's that done. So what are we going to do next? Well, the next section that is normally recommended to do is to do the Seafoam Islands next. Actually, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go to the Pokemart next. Oh, it's up there. See what I can get. Things like potentially antidotes and things. Nope, there's hardly anything here to buy. But I will sell you some stuff. Sell the X Special. That's all I want to sell him. Cripe. Alright. Into my bag. I'm going to give the Quick Claw to one of my slower Pokemon. I'm going to give it to Venusaur to hold until Venusaur gets something better. It raises the base attack stat of a Pokemon. I'm going to give that to Pidgeot. And that'll do. Right then. Let's head out towards the Seafoam Islands and Cinnabar Island. And I could theoretically fly to Pallet Town and down to Cinnabar Island now. And then I'm going to go to Route 19. I've already beaten this trainer, but I'm going to take on this trainer. Wait, slow down, you'll have a heart attack. Will I? Damn it. So Reese sends out Goldeen. Come on, Kadabra, do your thing. Yeah. So I've had a little look at the guidebook for this. And as long as I'm around about level 40 by the time I hit Cinnabar Island, I should be fine. Because in the Seafoam Islands, I get to try and catch an Articuno. Now, by the time I get to Elite Four, I should have either Articuno in my team or have Ice Beam on Vaporeon to take on Lance's Dragon types. Well, don't have Staryu. Yeah. There we go. Ooh, that's chilly. Well, yeah, you're wearing Speedos, dude. Come on, Vaporeon, let's go for a swim. And I get challenged for a trainer. I look at the sea to forget all the bad things that happened. You must be so depressed, dude. Ah, too many Speedos! I'm even KOing him with Psybeam, which is a weaker attack. have it. That's that. Nigel's now at 39. So Ninetales is about 3 levels higher . So Ninetales is my strongest Pokemon at the moment, level 39. I'm going to try and miss out some trainer battles. Tentacool, level 15. I don't actually own one, so I'm going to throw a Great Ball and see what happens. I'm not going to waste Ultra Balls on a Tentacool. Yeah, I've got one. Easy as pie. Nope. I'll try and avoid trainer battles. I'm going to throw some repels down because this is going to get really annoying really fast. Seafoam Islands. Ah, Pokeball right off the bat. An Ice Heal. That'd probably be useful against Articuno. Right, let's have a look around, see what I can find. Ooh, that's definitely going to go in that hole, hasn't it? So this puzzle, you've got to push all the boulders into the holes and it will give you a path to Articuno. You heard that cry, that's definitely an Articuno cry. Oh, there's a Pokemon stronger than me here. 24. Oh, just because repel all off. Go back to the bag and use another one. Let's see if I've got some super repels. I'll use those first. Oh, I fell down a hole. Whoops. Let's go back up. Back down the hole. Right, now I have to surf out, I have no choice. Then I can push this one. Yes, now I can surf around here without penalty now. So that's the other entrance. That's the lower entrance. So I need to go back in and try and find this damn dot. Go in, you stupid idiot. I think what I have to do with this is I push this one up twice. This one down one. Then across one. Then I have to move this one over. That one down the hole. And that one down the hole. There it is, Articuno. Right, okay, I'm going to save my game right here. I'm going to have... Yes, I will have Kadabra at the forefront of this. I think Articuno is level 40. So I'm going to have Kadabra at the forefront. Okay. I have no idea why that sounds like an Articuno, but it does. Legendary Pokemon, level 50. This is going to be hard. Start with a couple of flashes to try and stop it from attacking me. Let's see if I can lower its accuracy. Mind Reader. Took aim, right, okay. I'll see if I can lower its accuracy maybe three or four times before. Ooh, missed. That's just, I think that's just a low level ice attack. Or does it cover him? Become shrouded in mist. Protected by mist. Using agility again. Darn it. Right, okay. Let's go with a psychic. Because I'll more than likely need. That did bug all. This will probably KO Kadabra, no problem. Yeah, it does. Alright. Who am I going to send out? Let's send out Ninetales, see if I can get the burn on it. Well, actually, Confuse Ray might be useful. So I've lowered its accuracy by two stages. It's now confused. Mist now wore off. Oh, why did I use Confuse Ray again? Taking aim. Already confused. I know that. Now, Flamethrower is super effective. So I'm going to try one Flamethrower. Ice Beam, but I can't be frozen. But that could easily KO. Oh, it's not very effective. Good. This is very effective. Oh, it's super effective, but didn't get anywhere near the damage that I wanted. You know, if he hurts himself and I get the flamethrower through. Super effective. Right, I'm not going to hit it anymore. Let's go to the bag. Try an Ultra Ball. Oh, so close! Don't hit yourself, don't hit yourself! Right, use Mist. Now, if I could get Venusaur out safely... Let's try another one. Come on. Stay in the ball! Right, it's not going to hurt itself with that anymore. I don't even think I've got three Ultra Balls left. Should have really bought more. I should have bought more Ultra Balls. Oh, come on! I'm glad I used those flashes right at the start of the battle. My last Ultra Ball. Come on! Damn! Right, I've got to go to the Great Balls now. So I'm not wasting a Master Ball on a stupid Articuno. She's going to break out all of these. I can't risk attacking it again. Got 7 Great Balls left. Come on. Stay in the ball, Articuno. Come on. As soon as I get Articuno, it's the strongest Pokemon in my team. God damn! Just breaking out straight away. Just not doing anything with these Great Balls at all. Come on. One. Ah, fuck. Pardon my language. Got 3 left. What I want to do is I want to get Venusaur in to put it to sleep. Got 2 left. Nope. Well, it's my last ball. Damn. All right. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to run. I'm going to run, but I'm going to quit my game. I'm going to reload it, because I saved it right before the Articuno, and I'm going to try again. Saves it my quest to see if I mind. Right, this time I've got about 2, maybe 3 minutes, so I'm going to switch Venusaur up front. Hope to God I get a quick claw. Put it to sleep and chuck some bloody balls at it. Right, agility, that don't matter. I just need to get it to sleep and start grinding away at it. Just for some strength, so that's going to be my best option for now. It's going to be asleep at full 5 turns. I've got him into the yellow. He woke up. Used Ice Beam. This will knock out Venusaur. This has given me no choice in the matter. It's knocking out Venusaur. Alright, so I'm going to go with Ninetales. Throw a Confuse Ray out at it. Alright, so I use flamethrower, it's not going to do much. Even though it is an ice type. And once I get it in the red, I will try chucking ultra balls again. Because I'm not losing a legendary. Fuck! I've got the bloody crit. Oh, damn it! Load again. I'm critically ill, but don't care. I'm catching this Articuno this session. Attempt 3. It's my longest video now, and I'm catching this Articuno this session. I don't give a shit. Go with the sleep powder. Alright, go to sleep. Alright, switch out to Ninetales. Right, do a few flamethrowers, a couple of flamethrowers on it. Hopefully not crit it this time. Right. Fast asleep. As long as it's fast asleep for the next two turns, I should be fine. Right, one more. Articuno woke up. Come on! Right. I'm faster than it this time, that's a shock. Right, into the red. Missed Warlock. I'm going to throw a couple of Ultra Balls at it. So I've got 5. Probably have used 14 balls last time and still didn't catch the damn thing. 2 shakes and it's out. I'm really low on battery power now, so I may actually have to give this up and come back another day. Come on, go for it. Breaking out again, come on! One. And a break. God damn it! That's what I hate about legendaries, their catch rate is so low. Right, it's my 3rd or 4th Ultra Ball now. And a breakout straight away. Didn't even bounce. So I can't even risk burning it. My last Ultra Ball. Come on. Stay in the damn ball. Right, now I have 9 great balls. I don't use a fucking master ball on this. All of the legendary birds are at level 50. Come on, come on. Oh! No, it broke out again. Come on! No, it's not even doing it. If I run out of balls again, I'm just going to have to come back again and try again another day. I'm just going to go back to Future City and buy a ton of freaking Ultra Balls. It'd be alright if freaking Venusaur could tank an ice beam attack. So I can put it to bloody sleep. Nope, it's just breaking straight out without any issues whatsoever. Now if he attacks Ninetales again, I'll get a free switch into Venusaur. when we, if a quick corn kicks off, it'd be great. So I'll put it to sleep and then try again. So I'm down to 3 balls left and I'm not using that damn master ball. Nope. Nope, last one. No, that's it. I'm out of balls. I've only got my master ball left and I am not wasting it on our spooner. Alright guys, I'm going to have to leave it there. I'm going to have to come back to my old save file. And that'll have to be it then. So what I'll do is I'll come back to my old save file. I'll use an escape rope to get out of here back to Fuchsia City. Go and get a crap ton of Ultra Balls, because I know I can buy like 20 of the fickers. And then I'll come back and try again. Alright, that's Cosplayer signing off for the evening. I'll see you in the next video. Bye!